know the Golden Cat, not as a patron, mind you. I designed some... Corvo, my friend, do you need ammunition or weaponry? Would you like me to craft something for you?
Hello, Corvo. I expect Martin will be joining us shortly. I hate to start your day with such a strange matter, but the servants heard something last night, moving through the storm drains beneath the building. Most likely a weeper, the poor bastard. There's no hope for them once the plague gets that far along. Nothing more than a shuffling corpse full of sickness and insects, if you ask me. I'd appreciate you investigating, just to be sure it's not a nosy guardsman that's getting too close. Here's a key to the hatches. I tend a servant down there, but they die of fear on the spot, I'm afraid. Maybe Piero can concoct some sort of sleep poison for your crossbow if you want to go that route.
It is every citizen's duty to report treasonous speech and action. Safety depends on you.
You went down there in the sewers? I thought I heard a weeper in there earlier. You're probably the bravest man I've ever met. Overseer Martin has arrived. He's with Admiral Havelock now. They want to talk to you.
Corvo, I trust you remember Martin, an overseer before, and perhaps again someday soon.
I owe you thanks for my rescue.
Indeed. You've given us a glimmer of hope, Corvo. Because we've gotten what we wanted from Campbell's journal. You've done it. We know where Emily Caldwin is being held.
The Golden Cat, of all places. A bathhouse for aristocrats. Little better than a cursed brothel.
But there's an unfortunate twist. It appears that Pendleton's own kinsmen stand in our way. The twins, Morgan and Custis. Not only are they controlling Emily, but they have the controlling parliamentary votes we so desperately need.
Yes, the Pendletons have to die. But most importantly, Emily must be brought here safely so we can protect her until the Lord Regent and his entourage have been dealt with. Pendleton's waiting for you on the dock. He's asked to brief you personally. I think it's best.
Corvo, I've asked to speak to you myself. You see, I'm sending you to kill my older brothers, Morgan and Custis. They're horrible men. It's true, as you may have heard, cruel beyond words. Further, my brothers are close allies to the Lord Regent. And as long as they are in Parliament, we cannot gather the votes we'll need to stop the Lord Regent from further consolidating his power. These days, they're best known for exploiting their favor with him to cheat others out of their wealth. Let's just say that not every family evicted and quarantined for having the plague actually has the plague. I warned my brothers in every way I could. I really did. But they never did listen to me. They'll be at the Golden Cat tonight at their usual revels. They'll be protected by the City Watch, so it'll be dangerous. Now go. Please do it before I change my mind.
Corvo, my friend, do you need ammunition or weaponry? Would you like me to craft something for you?
I'll take you to the Golden Cat when you're ready. I've taken Lord Pendleton enough times, believe me. I'll get you as close as I can to the Golden Cat, Corvo. You'll have to go the rest of the way on your own. The entrance is near Holker Square. The main thing is to make sure that little girl, Emily, gets back all safe and sure. Them two Pendletons are there, so I'm guessing there'll be a lot of guards. Slackjaw might have some ideas on helping you get inside the Cat, if he don't kill you. This here's his territory. He and his Bottle Street gang hole up at the old Dunwall Whiskey Factory. They sell the elixir that folks use to fight off the plague. I'll lay low, but keep an eye out for you and the little lady you bring him back. Good luck to you. I know Emily must mean a lot to you. Be careful going up the street, Corvo. A river hand I know pulled up along... night and said there's one of those watchtowers on Clavering now. I guess you getting rid of Campbell shook up the Lord Regent.
Thank you.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Thaddeus Campbell, formerly High Overseer.
Slackjaw. Slackjaw. What kind of name is that anyway?
Hey, you're just the man I's looking for. Slackjaw's wanting to talk to you.
That him?
Yeah, he's the one.
They're gonna last much longer in there.
That's what they get for taking free swigs from the still. That tainted elixir is bad stuff, I guess.
What they call iron ready, I think. Elixir is supposed to prevent the flame from sliding off. But someone points it.
Easy, easy. You just need a bit.
Ain't you heard? Slack jump. Good stuff.
He is a villain if I judge your looks aright. A villain I might have some work for. Somebody put plague in the brute tank. Half my men are weepers. Trapped three of them in a distillery. Rest are wandering in the street. Since it's so, and I find myself short of able bodies, I may have a point of interest for you, see? Way I figure it, there ain't nobody worth killing round here except those two Pendletons over at the Golden Cat. I'm right, ain't I? See? Slackjaw knows. Them boys are twins. Rich, mean, and weird. Worse than most of their ilk. They've been laying low there a while, not sure why. There's a lot of security at the Golden Cat tonight, though. Special guests and the like. But you're gonna walk in there dressed like that and kill the Pendleton brothers? Maybe I got a better way to take care of them, too. If you're doing something for me first, understand? Someone, I don't know who, is killing my men, taking my territory, stealing my goods. Might be a fellow name of Galvani. I sent my best man to investigate, but he went missing and... Well, now I need someone to find what happened to him. Go to this Galvani's place. He lives nearby off Clavering Boulevard. You do that for me and I'll get you a better way into the Golden Cat.
Picked up anything good?
Huh.
Got anything to smoke or eat?
Blow off, Joffer.
He's gone.
See him?
Not like a lot of blood, really.
Wish I saw.
Not a big deal.
Maybe you can go up later and take a look after them other two are gone. Huh?
Suspects.
Suspects? What? Suspects? We ain't gonna waste time solving who killed him. Personally, I'd buy who did it a
But what are you gonna put on your report?
I'm gonna say we found one of Slackjaw's men inside, all dead and bloody, and that you are a stinking idiot.
Thank you.
just dies.
Hey, wait a bit. What just occurred to me? How come it's always me who pay for the whiskeys?
Shush up your mouth. You know I can't work out the right number of coin. It's embarrassing.
What's this? Information for my missing guy. Let's have a listen.
Slackjaw, it's me, Crowley. I'm making this in case I don't make it back. He was right. There is someone wants you dead. Wants to take over the distillery and the whole Bottle Street gang. And you'll never believe who it is, neither. At first I did. That's why it's taken me so long. I wanted to be sure. What's that? Fire! No! No! Ah!
So Crowley's dead. Too bad. He was one of my best men. Still, you and me had a deal, and Slackjaw never goes back on a deal. Take this key. It ain't for the Golden Cat, no. This key's for the captain's chair. A hotel abandoned since the plague gutted this part of town. Take the stairs to the top. You can use the roof to get into the Golden Cat brothel. See that? Slackjaw keeps a bargain. Just as good as them men who run the city. Maybe a little better. You think about that. Now maybe we can help each other out again. I could get rid of the Pendletons for you, quiet-like and without killing them. But you gotta do something for me in return. The Cat's having a big reopening tonight. Lot of money clients. including an arts dealer named of Bunting. He's got particular tastes, or so I've been told by some of the ladies. Got some pretty fancy stuff locked away at his place, and the only thing preventing me from nabbing all that loot is the combination to his safe. Of course, the Pendletons have been camped out there for months too, not sure why. So that means a lot of the City Watch and other soldier types. Bring me that combination, my masked friend, and then I take care of the Pendleton brothers, just like that. You ain't never even gonna touch them. And I promise, I won't kill them, and no one will ever see them again. Now if that ain't a deal, Slackjaw don't know what is.
Got anything to smoke or eat?
Want to look at some of the things I've found? Good prices, I swear.
Compliance is a punishable offense.
Come to dinner now, that's right, my sweet little birds. Come to Granny. Granny won't hurt you. My gentlemen callers don't come around like they used to. You took care of it for me, didn't you? That's nice. Have you seen him? The handsome one with the beautiful dark eyes. I just want to tell him I'm doing my part. Yes, Granny Rags is doing her part. Tell him.
Flash.
filthy mudlark? Let a tramp like you get elixir.
We've been on half rations for a week. I ain't catching the plague. Hand it over.
No, please. It's for my baby. He needs it. Thank you. Thank you, sir. You saved me. How can I thank you? I have nothing. Wait, take this. It's the backdoor service key to Bunting's house, the art dealer on the main street. I used to work for him, you know, before the plague. He's let all his servants go, but he's still there, probably hoping he'll be able to sell something from that safe of his. I don't know what he has left, but it's all I have to offer you. Please take it.
Nice.
The ivory room. All I can tell you is, it's very heavily. I'll leave it.
This whole place has gone to the hounds.
Why are you wearing that mask? Corvo? Corvo, it's you! You're wearing a mask to sneak around, aren't you? They told me you were head chopped off in the prison, dead, like Mother. That seems like a long time ago. But you're not dead. Now we can leave. I have a plan. I almost got away twice. There's a special door to come and go, for special people, and I'll show you. And if anyone tries to stop us, you can fight them. It's this way.
Wonder if anyone would notice if this was...
Thank you.
Johnson. The Pendletons are here. You're supposed to be on duty.
Come on.
You're supposed to be
on guard. You'll get dismissed for sure.
I can't believe this. You said you weren't even drunk. Wake up.
Finally. I've been like this for 20 minutes. Your footsteps sound a little loud. Have you gained a little weight, honey? Now, just like last time, understand? Slowly, and only trigger the shock at my command. Get it? And the safe word tonight will be retribution, let's say. You hear that, you stop. One shock out of line, and you are out of a job. Oh, that's good. I deserve that one. Shall I tell you why? The Pendletons are here, right? I'll start with them. I cheated them, robbed them of thousands. Oh, you're ruthless. Don't hold back. I'll tell you everything. The Pendletons' inheritance was worth hundreds of thousands at least. I told them it was junk. Retribution! Retribution! That was perfect. But it's all I can take for tonight. Call my servants. We're done. We're done, I said. Retribution! Now let me out! What the? Who is this? What do you want? The safe. Yes, of course. The combination is 879. Take anything you find. I think I felt my heart skip.
Prudence, the old hag. She caught me trying to get away. Now she keeps the key with her. You've got to find the keys with her.
Her hand dies.
This place is on the river.
Fussing with my collar, Mama. The dance is starting soon. Is my hair smooth enough? He's sure to be there.
Until a new High Overseer is chosen.
One more try. They wouldn't have such a strong door unless they kept some interest. On its other side. A flash.
You brought me the numbers. I've been after this combination for months. If you ever need steady work, you come see me. Slackjaw knows a good man when he sees one. It's only natural that you be curious about what I intend to do with the Pendletons. See, them Pendletons got these rock mines. Have hundreds of souls working down there half a mile deep below ground. So I'm gonna shave their heads and cut out their tongues and put them in one of their own stinking mines. Then they're gonna see life from a different angle.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. A mandatory whale oil...
Are you both ready to go? Corvo, you must have worked wonders out there in the city tonight. I can't believe my old eyes. So you did the business, did you, Corvo? I'm not one to speak against my betters, mind you, but if anybody ever deserved their fate, it was those Pendletons.
What business are you talking about?
Oh, grown-up business, girl. I mean, your ladyship. Forgive me.
It's okay. I heard a lot of grown-up business at the Golden Cat.
Oh. I should concentrate on piloting this boat.
Yeah. Young Lady Emily, I'm Callista. I'll be caring for you and schooling you while you're with us.
Pleased to meet you.
As am I. Would you like to see your room in the tower?
Can I see it?
Yes, you may. You'll get to see it all. The entirety of the Hound Pits.
Good. I think I'll like it here. I'll go with Callista, Corvo. I'll see you later.
You do not fail to impress. Armed with a blade, you've changed the course of the city forever. And with the Pendleton twins gone, our own Lord Pendleton will assume their votes in Parliament. In one night, you've done more than most men do in a lifetime. I need to speak to you soon. But for now, Lord Pendleton requests your attention.
Corvo, the Loyalist Conspiracy thanks you for your work. I don't know if I can. My own brothers. We never believed that you killed the Empress. It made much more sense that the Royal Spymaster, now the Lord Regent, was behind it, aided by some of his key allies. We spent a lot of money and exposed ourselves to great risk in getting you out of prison. But we did it because we believe that you're the one that can make the difference.
Oh, and Havelock's looking for you.
Ask me for any gear you need.
Martin's devised our next move. There's a footnote in Campbell's journal that tells us the Lord Regent's mistress sat for a portrait with Sokolov, the painter and royal physician. He'll be able to give us her name. Sokolov lives on Caldwin's Bridge about half the time, out over the river. The catch is that I'm afraid you've got to head out right away while Sokolov is at his apartment on the bridge. Samuel can get you close to the bridge, but you'll have to find Sokolov. Bring him back here intact. And it'll enable us to make our next move. I can't believe what you've done so far. Escaping from Coleridge, taking down the High Overseer, recovering Emily. You make this old military man proud. That's it, then.
Gamble's journal. It's amazing how many overseers he's been blackmailed. It really is.
Ask me for any gear you need.
Off to Caldwin's Bridge, sir. We'll get our sleep later. Just climb aboard when you're ready. What do you think, Corvo? Caldwin's Bridge. You've been in the city for years, but you lived in Dunwall Tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out for. See all them lights on the water? That's right. We'll be spotted for sure. You're gonna have to shut off their power before I can pick you up. Now, about bringing Sokolov back alive. He's smart. Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole of Dunwall under his thumb with all that natural philosophy business. New technology, potions, and the like. Seems dangerous to me. But what do I know? Here we are. I'll meet you at the arches under Sokolov's place when you're ready. We should take care of those floodlights.
You understand now. Curfew means ain't nobody allowed to be just wandering about, except us guards.
Flash the fire. Dies.
Tell me what you'll do if Slackjaw and his Bottle Street
bug someone else.
Let me know if you want to gamble on the hounds again.
Slow.
Thank you.
citizens and visitors to our city.
Nice.
The order of the region. The curfew is now active. No foot traffic. Vic is allowed across Caldwin's Bridge.
In this blasted curfew, how is anyone supposed to make a living?
Well now, Mr. Pratchett, even a wealthy man like you needs the city watch. Gangs are cutting throats and smashing windows left and right, and the weepers, excuse me, the plague victims are worse. Are you saying the Lord Regent is wrong for imposing curfew?
It won't do you any good to bait me, officer, but don't worry, I'll be fine. A smart man can come out ahead, even in the time of plague.
Sure, like that Sokolov. He's doing fine. Always a lot of exotic items coming and going from his place. Keeps this place running, at least for now.
Yes, yes, if by exotic you mean foul smelling as a witch's bottle. The royal physician will be fine too, until he crosses the wrong man.
Rivers change course over many lifetimes, and eventually all bridges tumble down. 1,000 years ago, there was another city on this spot. The people carved the bones of whales into runes and inscribed them with my mark. Children still find them washed up in the river mud. Anton Sokolov has made a great study of my runes, but he's not special like you are. He wasn't chosen, and he doesn't wear my mark, so he can't unlock their secrets. Sokolov believes there are specific words and acts that can compel me to appear before him. He searches old temples in Pandicia and ruined sub-basements in the flooded district. He performs disgusting rituals beneath the old abbey. But if he really wants to meet me, he could start by being a bit more interesting.
Touch the charger before your shift when the duty officer brings it by, and the ARC pylon will fry you.
Those things? Give me the willies, sir.
You'll be thankful when Slackjaw's boys come down the street to slit your ricker.
I hope he was smart enough to stash him someplace before I got caught.
You're the one playing when you scout these things.
That's right.
Scouting is when you find out what the guards are doing and come back.
Well, now we know what the guards are doing.
The reason you scout is so you don't end up in a cell. What Alec did was the exact opposite of scouting.
We saw the ARC pylons. They're still there.
Great. Yes, the pylons are still there. In case we want to go and get ourselves killed.
Look, are we gonna bust Alec out?
We're not. Eventually, sure.
just dies.
Why they always gotta put me with you, I just don't know.
Thank you.
I just love watching them turn and turn.
What, them wheels?
Yes.
Like the cycle of life.
Such a wondrous symbol.
I was just wondering if Sokolov is testing elixirs on people to cure the plague. Why is it he always asks for healthy citizens? I mean, if you follow my meaning, sir.
You have no mind for natural philosophy.
Obviously, it's because the ones already sick with plague don't live long enough to provide Sokolov with any information.
It's just a shame, sir. Like that woman the other day. She was easy to look at. Seemed nice.
She has to die. I mean, so horrible, too.
Now you listen to me. It's none of our concern how or why. And if you want your elixir, just stop.
So.
I'm not asking to know what's going on up there. Just asking if you heard the screams, too.
Of course I've heard them.
I was told that there were no screams.
What's that? A riddle?
Okay.
So, why would no screams worry you more?
Because it is our job to look after Sokolov and make absolutely sure he continues his work. The screams are evidence his work continues. Thus, the screams are evidence that I have done my job.
We. The screams are evidence we have done our job.
You know, Guardsman, I don't care for you very much.
So,
I have to keep this position.
He says to bring a bottle, I bring a bottle. He says to bring food, I bring food. He says to undress, I undress.
Well, without Sokolov and his strange things, you would probably be dead by now.
Can't one of our own doctors make a cure?
Don't
go upstairs and ask a madman yourself.
My daily elixir ration? I'm not that stupid.
If you say so. You two! Stop.
Should we gather for whiskey and cigars tonight? Indeed, I believe so.
I told her to keep the children in.
I told her.
now turn my hopes and energies to Formula 25, which, in conjunction with a high heat therapy, which came to me most vividly in a dream last night, has great potential.
What is this? Thank you, whoever you are. He kept me in a cage, like an animal. The pain is horrible right now. So I'll just hide in a corner and leave when I'm feeling better.
Position himself. He made a neat job of it. Drop him here and we'll be off.
All the others.
Set up a cell for Sokolov in the old kennel. Shackles and everything. It'll be a shock, him waking up in the straw and old dog poop. But from what I hear, he's woken up worse places. Guess we all have at that.
I doubt a dozen soldiers could have done it better. Sokolov's knowledge will enable us to strike at the Lord Regent directly, and ultimately help you get your life back. Soon, we won't have to hide in the shadows. The royal physician is brilliant, but he was a fool to protect the Lord Regent. Sokolov gave us the elixir, the war machine. He could have made us a great nation. Now he pays the price for siding with a tyrant. You have my thanks, sir. If you wish to get some sleep, now is a good time.
Normally, I'm a natural philosopher, but today, consider me a humble craftsman here to serve.
Corvo, wake up! You were making funny faces while you were sleeping. I decided to nap here in your room while Callista was taking her bath. She told me if there's ever trouble, I should always run here. Callista will come get me when she's done with her bath. Thanks, Corvo. It makes me feel better.
Alright guys, thanks for watching. We'll switch games in a bit. So, hopefully I'll see some of you guys when I'm playing my other game.